So if you live in a low-lying place, a place like Miami, you could see several floods a year by the middle of this century. Floods that cause significant damage. This is what a new report by NOAA predicts Miami in particular might look like in 2050. Look at all of that land lost with an additional foot of water around its coasts. And places like Texas, NOAA believes sea levels could be a foot and a half higher than current levels. Again, this is the prediction for 2050. The new report by NOAA also finds that sea levels are already rising by alarming rates. And the report suggests those sea levels will rise more in the next 30 years than they did across the entire 20th century. Joining me now is Michael Mann, Penn State Distinguished Professor and Director of their Earth System Science Center. He's also the author of the book, The New Climate War. Michael, it is really good to see you. It has been far too long, my friend. This new report by NOAA, we're often looking for specifics. It's hard for science to predict what's going to happen specifically. But looking at a foot of sea level rise by 2050, which is still in most of our lifetimes, and what it's going to do to a place like Miami, it's pretty shocking.
Yeah, Katy, it is great to be back with you. This is, you know, a sobering report. There's no question about it. There is some increased confidence. We have more observations, more data. We're measuring what's happening with these ice sheets, with these collapsing ice shelves. Our models, our climate models, are more comprehensive. They better handle some of the complex physics of how ice behaves in these ice sheets. And because of all of that, we have quite a bit more confidence now. And what we can say is that, yeah, there's about a foot of additional sea level rise by mid-century, just a few decades down the road, that's baked in. That's going to happen. We can't really do anything about that. We're going to need to adapt to those impacts that are baked in. But the fact remains that we can prevent the worst. We can, you know, we're committed maybe to a foot of sea level rise here by the middle of the century, but we can prevent meters of sea level rise from ultimately taking place, where we would see, you know, vast inundation around the world and catastrophic consequences. So yeah, some bad stuff is locked in. We're going to need to adapt to that and reduce, you know, the suffering that results from that. But at the same time, we can prevent the worst by cutting carbon emissions rapidly.
So I feel a little bit like we are being shown exactly what's going to happen in the future, or not exactly. We're shown an idea of what could happen in the future. It's like we're looking up at the sky and seeing a comet come towards us, like that movie that just came out. And there's a good portion of the population that sees it and says, yeah, I see it. It's coming. We've got to do something about it. And there is a solid portion of the population who refuses to see it. And then there's a portion of the population who sees it and wants to do something but doesn't want to disrupt their lives as they currently stand. How do you not get really cynical and really depressed, Michael?
Yeah, well, you know, the film is Don't Look Up, but in this case, we've got, you know, one of our two major parties that doesn't want to look down. They don't want to look down at the warming of the ocean and the sea level rise that's already having disastrous impacts on red states like Florida, which is seeing some of the worst consequences. So, yeah, it is frustrating. For those of us who watched the film, Don't Look Up, it was both amusing at the same time, very sort of disconcerting, because we are facing this. We are facing a politically motivated, belief system that denies this, you know, catastrophe that is unfolding in real time, not as quickly as the comet that strikes the planet in the film, but quickly enough that we're seeing these devastating consequences, these floods that now occur far more often along the U.S. East Coast, sunny day flooding, where it doesn't even take a storm now to flood the streets of Miami Beach and other cities along the U.S. East Coast. So it's happening. That comet is arriving in slow motion, and we've got to do something before it strikes.
I know it's a satire, it's a comedy. Adam McKay is a funny guy, but there's so much truth that I found it to be a bit of a horror horror movie, yeah. Michael, I have to say. Got a little mad at my husband last night for making me watch it, because I just wanted to go to bed thinking happy thoughts. I'm going to put my head in the sand, which is probably the wrong thing to do. Michael Mann, always good to see you. Thank you so much. Please come back soon.